Oh, nope. I was gonna surprise you, but I failed! It was on the wrong scene!
Fail.
Hello and welcome to the Game of Jazz Duo podcast number 35. Oh man, that was so sad. It was on the first scene. I'll probably include that. I am TBCAC, one of your hosts, alongside... Oh, but you can call me Teddy. And this guy's Eric.
Yeah, Eric, also known as Legend PVM on Twitter.
It's true. We are an entertainment podcast that mostly focuses on video games, comics, TV, coming up real soon. Real, real soon. But there's a little bit of TV to talk about. Superheroes, movies.
Walking Dead.
That would be included in TV. And comics and video games, I guess you can say. But, yeah. PlayStation and Destiny. All sorts of stuff like that. So,
and sometimes Xbox, because we have Xboxes.
Yeah. Now. Thankfully.
Yeah.
And PCs every now and then. There's a little bit of that.
Actually, a lot of PC stuff is this
week, yeah. So, normally we start off by talking about what we've been playing in the past week. And since we did not podcast last week, it has been 2 weeks.
Yep.
So we've been playing a lot of things. 2 weeks ago, we pretty much spent the whole week playing Black Ops 3 Beta.
That and moving.
Yeah, for
I
both
moved
of
rooms
us.
And Teddy,
Oh, yeah.
In college.
I'm in a dorm.
In a dorm. That's kind of a big thing.
there's an Asian over there, so.
Whoa, racist!
You know. We're in different places. It took us a while. On last Sunday, I think Eric was free, but me and Ryan were... It was the welcome week for the college or whatever, so there was a ton of, required... Yeah. things that we had to go to. Like, we couldn't even watch Fear the Walking Dead live because the required things ended at 9:30, so we immediately drove over to my house.
Apparently if you didn't go to them, you get smacked in the butt. Like, hey, get
literally,
out of here.
Somebody comes up and smacks you in the butt.
It's and like, hey, get out of our college.
You're done here.
You're done.
You're done here. I know you've been here for one day, but just because you missed this
I'll
one
get
session
the belt.
It's over. So we couldn't do it last week. There wasn't too much to talk about other than the beta. There was basically the beta and...
Yeah, and the reveal. The tower reveal.
Yeah, so, we have
we should probably talk Destiny, towards the end, since there's a lot to cover. Because there's two reveals, and a lot of information, too.
So... what have we been playing? Black Ops 3, 2 weeks ago. This past week, Dishonored for me. Literally, whenever I've had the chance, and I haven't been playing, anything, social. If I'm not playing, something with friends, and if I'm not doing homework, I was playing Dishonored.
How are you liking it so far?
Literally on the last mission.
Yes.
In the walls, and then I had to go. I was like, gosh dang. I like it. I don't want to give my full impressions with it until I'm done.
My opinion on it is that it's a solid game. It's a good game. There's nothing outright wrong and bad about it. That's like, oh, look at me, I'm bad. This is a bad feature or something. And there's nothing like that in the game.
I have opinions on it. I definitely do have opinions on it, but I mean, they're not bad. They're not, I have thoughts
it's
on
also
it,
like a
but
some,
I don't want to.
Some people not like that kind of game.
I don't want to fully talk about my opinions on it because I'm at the point I was telling Ryan earlier is that I'm at the point where where I'm at, the ending could sway some opinions easily.
I forget the ending.
Yeah. So. I don't want to talk about it too much until I do it. So I'll talk about it next week. I will probably literally finish it today.
It's funny because the ending gets kind of spoiled by the Dishonored 2 trailer.
Yeah, I don't expect
you don't know the
her
ending,
to,
so I just
I don't expect Emily to die from knowing the trailer now. But I mean, that's not a huge thing. I wouldn't have expected her to earlier. But, yeah,
So we'll talk about that later. Basically those two games for me. Oh, we
Yeah.
freaking our RA on our floor in this dorm likes PlayStation All-Stars and Mod Nation Racers. So I played a little bit of that because those games are awesome. No, I'll go to my
Yeah.
grave saying that. But that's basically it. That first week I played nothing but Black Ops 3. Next week I played basically nothing but Dishonored. We played a little bit of Last of Us yesterday and a little bit of Destiny. And that's it.
And
Last of Us multiplayer. Ryan has the Last of Us multiplayer, so now we can actually play that.
Black Ops 3 is good. Very good.
Yeah, we'll talk about that. What else? You have a couple of things that you've been playing.
Well, I'm playing Destiny. If I do get on, it's probably PvP. Haven't been doing much otherwise. That we played some PoE last night. That was good. Got my
Yeah.
second exotic. What is it? The Elder Cipher exotic. Lord of Wolves. And I also been playing Guild Wars 2 on PC. I haven't been on since that news broke
Yeah.
yesterday, so.
There's one big thing that you're missing out of that list.
Until Dawn.
Yeah. There's that.
I bought it like the second day it was out. I was like, this game, oof.
I called it. I called it. I knew it was gonna be good. I knew it was gonna be good.
You know, it's
From.
funny because I kept looking at it. I was like, what is this?
Yeah, you're always like, eh, I don't know, it doesn't look very
So
good.
campy,
I'm just
these
like.
characters just seem oh, so unlikable. But the thing is, they just go from like purposely unlikable to freaking amazing. And it, so far, I mean, I guess I'm covering my impressions right now, but 10 out of 10 so far. 10 out of 10, besides the 27 frames sometimes. Ugh. It's kind of like Unity in terms of frame rate.
Yeah, I imagine that it wouldn't matter too much in that game compared to
It's not,
others.
like, it doesn't bother me that much, but,
Yeah.
like, sometimes you're trying to do, it's in an action sequence, and you're just like, stop, stop,
Yeah.
stop.
Like when we went over and when we were playing Mod Nation Racers over there, it split into four screens because we were all playing four, split screen. And Ryan played like two races and then he was like, he's done. And then later I was like, it was the frame rate, right? And he's like, yeah. Yeah, it was. It was like the four player
Is that
split
bad?
screen got down to like, it would just randomly drop to like 20. It was bad. It
Whoa,
was bad.
whoa.
But like, and
That's
then I was
uncalled
like, you
for.
would like that game because it's freaking normally it's fine. It's like really good frame rate, but four player split screen, that's why there's none in Halo. Get over it, kids. So yeah. That's what we've been playing the past week, I believe, unless we forgot something, which probably, but oh well. Doesn't really matter because there's a lot of news to talk about. I want to start off talking about a really small little bit of news that not too many people are paying attention to, but I think is really awesome. Runic Games, developer of Torchlight 2, has announced their new
They're
game.
cool.
I
Really?
really like Torchlight 2. That's why I honed in on this. And if I can, if this article would load, I can give you the good bit of information about it. Here it is. All
The
right.
thing is, I really liked the way that game was,
No.
how like the mechanics worked and all that. How Torchlight 2 just felt. Like, I mean, Diablo is good, but I just like the art style
Yeah, I like
and
Torchlight
the
2 better,
feel.
to be totally honest. I like the feel and the
And the
universe.
controls were
Yeah.
really good too.
Yeah, I
Just felt
agree.
really good.
I really like Torchlight 2 a lot. But this is not an action RPG in any way. Hob is an adventure game. This is the best paragraph that I saw out of it. Hob is an adventure game where you play a mysterious character who wakes up on what seems to be an unknown planet. You have to figure out why you're there and what you're doing. There's a lot more to the narrative than we're used to. There is combat, which in motion looks like the sort of battles you would see in a modern Zelda game, but you have to explore the world and solve problems. You have to learn about what's going on. So basically a Zelda game. Like, that's what it seems like, and I
Yeah,
am
I can
okay
see
with
that.
that because that sounds gosh dang awesome.
I
Here's some art from it. Looks really, really cool from all this little stuff that we're seeing. So yeah, Hob from Runic Games. Be on the lookout for that. I feel like it's probably far off. It's probably like a year or two away, but it looks really... Like, just the idea is awesome. I'm a big fan of that. Big fan. So, Eric.
What?
What do you think is the most important bit of news here?
Since
we started off small.
Well, let's start out with YouTube gaming.
Okay. That's not really the most important, but it's certainly interesting, that's for sure. Everyone,
I have no idea what it is, but...
Okay. You want me to talk about it?
I just opened it. What's this?
Colin and Greg talk about this a lot, and they keep talking about it as a topic. Is will YouTube gaming kill Twitch? The answer, no. I don't understand people with that opinion. It might in like 10 years, but there is a lot of work that they have to do. And
I mean, so YouTube gaming launched has 44,000 viewers.
How many does it have on Twitch?
Probably like 100,000.
Probably that's how it works. And it was on YouTube before YouTube gaming was even a thing. They've always been there. Riot Games. Riot Games on Riot Games on Twitch has 236,000 compared to 44,000. Sorry, I don't get it because
I mean
I don't get people's opinions that they thought it was gonna like compete with Twitch because it's not going to.
I see what it's used for. I see what it is. I get it, but
it's badly formatted. There's no moderation system for the chat, so the chat is still AIDS, I believe. I believe there's no moderation system. The donation system is only through like a Google system. The copyright claim system is still there. The website itself is badly formatted, and the copyright claim system is going to kill this game, this system, this site, before it even has a chance. Like, the copyright system would ruin it. If there's some game, Life is Strange has music in the game that just instantly will take it off YouTube. And if you're streaming it, it will just instantly take your stream down.
It's not gaming friendly.
So, it's not YouTube friendly. It's friendly on Twitch. But it will just instantly take your stream down if you're playing music that is copyrighted. And that's going to kill this before it has a chance to go anywhere. And, again, the website is badly formatted. There's no moderation system. They need to improve the
first
donation.
Thing that you need to work
and
on if they're
going
to try anything is, tell me what I'm clicking on. I don't know what I'm clicking on here.
Yeah, I don't know what you're talking about. It's easy. It's not hard. It's not that hard to understand. But
no, I just don't know what I'm looking at here. What are these buttons? They don't tell me what to do.
The buttons uploads. On the side?
Why are there uploads? This is like a live streaming thing, right? I just don't understand.
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't see any uploads. I see channels. My channels.
You have to open the channel first.
Oh, well, they probably have uploads for them. It's probably like a regular YouTube channel, but mixed more with the live aspect.
Yeah.
That part's not really that hard to understand. But I rest my case that there's a lot that needs to be done on that before that has any chance. Sorry, the whole notion that they were gonna come out of the gate swinging at Twitch is what I always thought was crap, and now it's proven. Hashtag Teddy was right. Let's see. Let's quickly talk about the Black Ops 3 beta because it was awesome. It was really, really good. It happened 2 weeks ago on PlayStation, and basically the consensus
completely broken on PC. I can't use it for some reason. It's just me, I guess.
I've never tried. Now that I'm thinking about it, let me.
I can't.
Let me give it a shot. Let me give it a shot. So let's just talk about the game, our opinions with it. I didn't love Advanced Warfare, but I didn't hate it like a lot of people. A lot of people just hated Advanced Warfare. I wasn't a big fan of Ghosts. I enjoyed it for like a month, but then I could very much see that it wasn't like, it very much wasn't, it didn't have a lot of longevity and stuff. So Ghost and Advanced Warfare weren't big fans of. Black Ops 2 was really good, but it came out in a time where I wasn't playing, like I wasn't really playing Call of Duty, I was playing a lot of PC games. So I haven't really been excited for a Call of Duty in like 3 years. And I played this beta, and it has made me more excited than I've been for a Call of Duty in 3 years. Like, it is very, very good. The Specialist is a really good change. The movement feels really nice. The hit detection, at least on PS4, is really, really good. So that is my opinion. I'm very excited for the actual launch. It was a great beta. I had a lot of fun. I played it all week.
Teddy.
Ryan just got the gosh dang ram in the Nightfall. Oh my gosh.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Teddy. You wanna just send that over to me? That'd be nice. God.
It'll be there tomorrow.
Anyways. Yeah, Teddy still doesn't have the ram on Destiny, so rip.
Only exotic that I don't have. Eric, what were your opinions on the beta.
It was perfect. I'm gonna use the words from Hutch. It has like, it's more lethal than a lot of Call of Duties, but it's a good thing because everything kind of counteracts each other, and everything has a way of having like its counters, almost, you could say.
Yeah.
And you're not getting your specialist stuff like every 5 seconds. It still takes some time and several kills to get your specialist ability, so.
Yeah.
It's fairly balanced right now. A lot of people are saying the Razorback is OP, but I'm not seeing that at the moment. Like, it's good. It's really good.
Whoa.
But,
your mic just like doubled in volume. Yeah. Is it? And now it's fine?
Yeah.
That was weird.
Now.
You're still fine.
Okay.
Yeah. That was.
I opened Call of Duty.
Oh, what the? That's so weird. All right.
Yeah, I don't know why I did that.
Anyways. So yeah, we really enjoyed the beta.
It was really great.
That's great.
Yeah, the PC beta ends tomorrow.
Yeah, and PC and Xbox One.
PM Central.
Yeah. So, look forward to Black Ops 3. Speaking of impressions on early access things, legit segue right there. I played a little bit of the WildStar free-to-play closed beta the other day, just to like see the character creation changes and a little bit of the changes. And I didn't really get to see much. I came out and I played like 3 levels, like I did the tutorial. But from what I saw, like the character creation alone is so much better. The character creation is really nice now. There's a thing for the, this is just for the closed beta, but I thought I would point this out there because this is a really good way to do a closed beta. As soon as you come out of the tutorial, there's a guy that's like, hey, I have a quest for you, and the quest just makes you level 50 and takes you to the capital. I'm like, all right, that's wow. Nice. It's a good idea for people just coming in to test things for a closed beta, you know? Because most of the game is the end game, so it just gets you right there for the beta, which I thought was cool. I just thought it was weird. I came over to this guy, and I was like, oh, there's a quest. All right, let me just complete this. And I'm like, oh, I'm level 50. I didn't even want to do that. But yeah, so it's looking really good. The shop is awesome. I did not get to test out like the always on sprint. I really want to, but I'm very, very much looking forward to WildStar.
Is it not there yet?
I didn't really notice it. I didn't really beat the tutorial. I just played like the first level because I just wanted to see the character creation. So I like killed 2 things outside of it and then was like, okay, I ain't got time. So I didn't get to see that. So yeah, really cool. Look forward to that when that goes free to play. Legit. I am so excited for that. Speaking of games going free to play, kind of, sorta. Oh, yeah. Another segue. I'm on fire. Eric can probably speak more about this than me, so I'll let you take the reins.
Yeah. So, Guild Wars 2, just out of the blue, just was like, hey, free to play. I didn't even know this was coming or anything. They just said it and it randomly happened. So basically what they're doing, and it's kind of amazing how they're doing this, like most free to play stuff that goes to free to play, it's either because they're either having an income problem or a player shortage or something like that. I'm not too sure what WildStar's
it's thing player was. Shortage. I'm gonna be real.
Yeah,
it's because they launched and a lot of the endgame stuff was broken and the game wasn't optimized very well. It was a whole big process to apparently even get into raids. So they had to change that because a lot of people didn't like it and it kind of just put people off of the endgame. Right. And it wasn't optimized well, so. Yeah. There's a couple of things that people
optimization
just, and one. The game is a lot better than it was when it originally launched, but nobody really knows that, so that's why.
Yeah, but yeah, like most games that or MMOs that go to free play, it's because of player shortage, income shortage, or something like that. I honestly don't think, from the stats that they put out, Guild Wars, they are doing this. Honestly, because of probably a player shortage, but most likely just to get more people in their system. And so, like, there's it's going to introduce a lot of more people. So everyone can download the game for free and get the base game with, like, they said 40 small expansions, and some of them are big, I guess. 40 major content releases, that's what it says. And basically, you'll be restricted, kind of like World of Warcraft trial. You can't yell in the world, and you can't do certain trading or something, that kind of stuff.
Interesting.
You can't and then there's level requirements. If you have bought the game like I have, you unlock world versus world at like a certain level. And you get PvP at like level five or something like that. But if you come in the free to play, you can't do PvP until you're like level 20, stuff like that. They're putting all these precautions to prevent PvP or no, free to play accounts from like becoming like spies and bots and gold farmers and stuff like that.
Yeah,
so,
which is easy to do.
Yeah, they've done a pretty good job of that. So basically, what they're doing here is for people who really love the game, you can get the new, I'm guessing, expansion, major release, new release of Guild Wars 2 Heart of Thorns, and that will, if you're free to play and you buy it, you'll get all the stuff that people who bought the game originally, and then on top of that you'll get the expansion when it comes out. And it's the same, and basically it's, everyone plays free and it's buy to play still. No monthly things or anything like that. There's not even like a subscription thing to have better stuff or anything like that. It's just buy it. There's cosmetics and it's good.
So to clear a couple of things up, it's not the general free to play business model where they're not going to be hitting you over the head with microtransactions, like you said, an optional sub. It's just free with a little bit of
no. There's no optional sub. It's just buy, play, free to play, play. So
Basically, let me find the paragraph. Also, another bit of information is that The Heart of Thorns is coming out on October 23rd. Thought mm-hmm. I would let people know about that. Let's see here.
Also, more than 5 million copies of the original game have been sold. That's something.
Let's see here. Where is it? They basically just talked about how... I can't find the exact sentence, but it was basically them saying, we're doing this because we are confident that whoever downloads this game will buy Heart of Thorns. And that's it. Like, dang, that's super ballsy. That is literally like Bungie / Activision being like, all right, Taken King's $40. Destiny, House of Wolves, Dark Below, it's free. Go download it. Go play it. And you know, we want you to do that because we know that you're gonna buy the Taken King if you play it. So there you go, it's free.
Yeah,
which would never happen because Activision. But
I like crazy. This sentence here, where they say, "Are we gonna be one of those games that aggressively monetizes free players through microtransactions?" Absolutely not.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Star Wars 2 remains the same game. Yeah, I think that's what you said, but. So,
yes, it is. But it's great. This is seriously insanely good news for the industry in general. Like this is saying that you don't have to nickel and dime everything. You really don't.
Yeah.
So
it's really good.
Look into that, devs/publishers.
Basically, what I'm doing with Guild Wars is between Destiny's major content releases, I'm probably going to be playing Guild Wars 2.
Dang, son, where'd you find this? What else? Oh, quick bit of news. So to wrap that up, though, go download Guild Wars 2. Just go do it, because it's literally free, so go do it.
No reason not to, unless you have a crap exactly. PC. There you go.
Exactly. I just want to toss this out there. This is a quick little bit of news. There are going to be new game modes, not game modes, but new difficulty levels in the Uncharted Collection. And one is super easy, so that you can play the story and enjoy it. One is called a speedrun mode. So there's a timer.
Dude, that's awesome.
And then another is brutal difficulty mode, which is harder than crushing.
That sounds brutal.
It's more brutal than crushing. So, rip. But I'm going to play through it, and I'm going to get the platinum, so. Gonna do it.
What if it's death mode on Sound Shapes? I wonder if it's just a timing thing. It's just crushing with a timer on top of it.
That's not it at all.
Because crushing. What? You just could get one shot by everything.
It's a good point because crushing is already really, really, really hard.
Well, yeah, and just the going from crushing, which is of, three hits.
The only thing that I can think of is that they might add more enemies. Yeah, like varied enemy placement and stuff to mess with your freaking head. It's possible.
Ooh. Yeah, on the shipyard one on Uncharted 3 that you were having trouble with. What if they just, swaps up the spawn points?
Can we not? Can we never do that, ever? No, I'm quitting life, if that's how it is. But I'll still beat it. okay, I am so excited for freaking Uncharted Collection. Just want to toss this out there about Vixen. It was good, but it was 5 minutes. So that's something. Basically, they're making it... Vixen is the animated show that's in the Flash and Arrow universe. The Flaro universe, as the kids are calling it. Basically, the Elicity universe. It's an animated show, basically. But the first episode was only 5 minutes, so I was really confused. Basically, they're releasing, 6 5-minute episodes as, a pilot. So, if people like it and watch it enough, then they will consider bringing it to live action. which is interesting. I really liked the episode, but as I was telling Ryan, the credits rolled, and he goes, that was it? And I was like, no, that can't be. And then I moused over it, and I was like, oh, I guess that was it. Because I thought those were the intro credits. I'm like, crap. Yes, I see your goldfish. Mm-hmm. I'm jealous of your goldfish. Because I ran out of mine recently. Ryan still has, like, two bags. Ryan
you
has
had a gallon.
Big... Yeah.
You had a gallon.
Oh, yeah. It was gone in, like, 5 days. Yeah. It's an issue. It's a real problem that America
is
facing.
Like, 140 calories per 55 pieces. That's actually not too bad.
Oh, yeah. That is now that I'm thinking about it. But still, I got no regrets.
No regrets.
No regrets, too.
There was a lot of sodium, though.
Yeah, I'm going to die of
250...
high cholesterol.
Oh, there's a lot of carbs. 20 grams. Woo!
420 grams. All right. Well, let's see here. What do we want to talk about? Do we want to talk about Fear the Walking Dead or?
Yeah, sure. Let's get that out of the
Okay.
way.
Bring in Fear the Walking Dead. I want to spend a bit talking about this because it was really good. So,
it was.
Fear the Walking Dead.
And I don't know what the heck is wrong with Andrew.
I don't know either. What the heck is wrong with Andrew? So Fear the Walking Dead premiered last Sunday night at 9:08
It was too slow. It's funny. I have two coworkers that watch Walking Dead, and they both watched this, and they're like, "Oh, it's too slow." I'm like, "Yeah, I saw that coming right from your mouth."
Oh, that's so gross. Too slow? I don't understand. It's not
supposed to be slow. It's not whether it's slow or not. It's supposed to be like that. They're trying to explain what's going on in the universe in an interesting way.
Great.
Rather than just like, zombies everywhere.
zombies everywhere now. So, it premiered last Sunday night. It had... I found this article as I was compiling topics. Fear the Walking Dead has the biggest premiere in cable history.
Wow.
By Cassidy Moser. It says... With a total of 10.1 million live viewers in all key demos, the 90-minute series premiere episode of Fear the Walking Dead has toppled The Walking Dead's initial premiere viewership numbers of 5.35 million in 2010, which at the time broke the record for biggest cable premiere ever. It has also vastly surpassed Better Call Saul's then-record premiere of 6.88 million people, set back in February.
Really? That show got a lot of... What? Okay.
It's the freaking spinoff to Breaking Bad. Breaking Bad's like considered one of
like
the best TV
the,
shows ever.
It's like one of my favorite shows.
I know.
And I got like two episodes in.
Yeah, but you watched the premiere though.
Premiere
Think
was
about
great.
Great. Think about that. But you watched it.
I watched it.
Yeah.
On internet.
Yeah.
Well, the next day.
So. Well, you're the exception. 6.8 million people watched it. So yeah. Fear the Walking Dead was really good, really popular, but I just want to say this. I came into that show thinking my number one worry about it was that it was going to take, that it was sadly going to take the route of Walking Dead Season 2, and it was just going to freaking take forever to explain stuff. Like, at the end of the season, we were going to see a zombie. Like, it was all going to be rumors, blah, blah. And then... No, like, it was perfectly paced, in my opinion, for the pilot episode. Perfectly paced. The pacing was on point. And all the characters I thought were really good and really interesting. Nick was a little bit annoying, but not really. By the end of the episode, I was down with Nick. I thought he was cool.
Yeah,
Nick's awesome. So, my number one worry was, like, completely opposite of what the truth was. Like, I was worried it was going to be super slow and the pacing was going to be awful, and then it was absolutely perfect and the pacing was great. Like, it's not going to be Rick and gosh dang Michonne out there just killing everything looking for gosh dang supplies or getting raided. It's not going to be that every episode.
People
think
now you
stupid.
Think about it, like, sometimes I wonder what they think about an episode. Like, I think we need like 3 supply episodes and maybe 2 episodes of people bickering. There we go.
Yeah, I don't get people who said that it was slow, because like for the origin of like showing off it as it happens, it was so perfect. They like the dude was talking about it at the beginning, like the kid Tobias, and then it was like it was really good foreshadowing, and then later like we saw, well, the show opened with a walker. Like, it opened with him running from a walker, and then there was like some character development, some foreshadowing, and then freaking gosh dang, like they saw it on the side of the road, and then at the end it was this whole big fight. Like, it was really, really good. I liked it a lot. That's what I have to say about that. And all of us agree except for Andrew. Jared thinks the same, you think the same, and Ryan thinks the same. And Andrew's like, oh, it's so slow. I don't like it.
Like,
so.
I don't get it.
I honestly don't get it. Also, Ryan, we may have planned our.
It's kind of like him not using. It's like kind of like me not using tactical.
It is exactly like that. but I think we may have planned our night wrong because the pilot was 90 minutes. So we might not have time. So rip. We're driving over to. Our plan is to drive over to my house. We're gonna pick up a pizza from Pizza Hut at 6:45. Drive over and watch the first episode again before we watch the new episode live, because we liked it so much. We're gonna watch it again, but we might not have time now. It was 90 minutes including commercials though, right?
Yeah.
Freaking, is it a 60 minute total?
Something like that.
We'd have to start it like as soon as we got back with our pizza. It might be close. But, you know, even if we're not live, even if we're like 5 minutes off, we'll catch up through the first commercial.
Well, let's get through this then. We got some top Tapix here.
Tapix? Got some Scotch Tapix. All right. Let's go over the Xbox.
I haven't seen these.
Also, I'm kind of taking my time because we do have time. It's we're 37 minutes in, so, we got time. So these are the Xbox Live and the PS Plus games of the month. Let's go over it.
Dude.
Of September. Xbox Live. Let's see here. They have certain dates, and I'm trying to go through the dates. Let's see. Xbox One.
The Deer
God. Okay, so... The Deer God, which Deer has God. Kind of, I see what you did there. It has sort of, it has, like, it's a cool cover. That's all I know, but, freaking download and play it because it's free. And then the biggest one on this, other than the last one, but this is freaking still the biggest one because it's on the new console. Tomb Raider Definitive Edition, available September 16th through October 15th. So the latter portion.
Crazy.
Battle Stations Pacific for Xbox 360, September 1st through 15th, and then Crysis 3, which is cool for 360, the 16th through the 30th. Also,
I enjoyed that game thoroughly.
Little known, little fact that I'm not sure if you knew: all the 360 games from last month forward will be backwards compatible. Crysis 3 is gonna be backwards compatible, and I will have it. So, just saying. I get that in a couple of months, basically. And Battlestorm Pacific, man. Battle Stations Pacific, heck yeah.
Nice.
Look at that gosh dang cover art. It looks just like a really bad arcade like piloting game. That's what I assume. But you know, don't judge a book / game by its cover. So really, really solid month for.
And you know, I just realized. Look at the cover for Crysis and then Tomb Raider.
Are they very similar? Are they both like holding bows? Probably. I closed the link. Hold on, give me a second. Yeah, they're. Oh my gosh, they're both the exact same like position too.
I just noticed that. I was like, what?
That's crazy. Here, viewers, look at them both shooting their bows.
But, the bow in Crysis 3 is really awesome. It's exactly like the sparrow. From you can have different arrows as on your, but it was not a power weapon. It was a weapon that you can just have in your.
There
loadout.
Were like full game modes that were like about the bow.
Also, in Crysis 3, you could pick up pipes, and smack people across the face with one-hit kills. It's amazing. And you can throw the pipe like a javelin.
Game of the year.
And
pipes,
like
mate.
A spear.
Heck yeah.
And you can just like hit people with it. It's so funny. I want to see a pipe montage. Pipe.
Pipe. Crysis 3 pipe montage. Let me
Crysis
just.
Crysis 3.
All right. Okay. So really solid month for both platforms. I just want to say that. PlayStation Plus. A couple of weeks ago, they started an initiative for that you can vote for one of your PS Plus games, one of your free PS Plus games. So there's an option of three different ones, and Grow Home got the winner. So that'll be available in September on the PS4. Also, I don't know anything about that game, but I have been like, by popular demand, it won, and like everyone is like excited about it in the kind of funny page. So I'm probably gonna like it. just from that. Super Time Force Ultra, which I am so excited about for PS4 and Vita. We've been waiting for that game for gosh dang like 2 years now. Friggin' get to play Shuhei Yoshida sending out tweets. Oh yeah. PS4 and Vita. Zio Drifter for PS4 and Vita. Not sure about that. It looks kind of like a 2D side-scroller.
Yeah.
Platformer. Twisted Metal for PS3. Tesla Grad for PS4 and PS3. Not sure what that one is. And then La Mulan X. Is that what that is? Yeah, La Mulana X. Is a PS Vita game. It is a riddle-filled adventure. Oh, that's a puzzle. That's a puzzle game for the Vita. So four PS4 games, which is awesome. I always like it when the ones are cross-buy and then it's like, freaking, they're sneaking in extra ones for the PS4, which makes me happy. So yeah, really solid month for both platforms. I am excited for Time Force Ultra. I'm excited for Crysis 3 when I can play that. It's gonna be good. So there you go. You are getting so many games nowadays if you have both, like if you have both consoles and the membership for them. Just getting games left and right just for fun. It's like, oh, here, have this.
Have this.
Oh gosh. So I think we can spend the remaining time of the podcast talking about Destiny.
Yeah.
Go for it. That was my cue. I was drinking water.
Let's see. Okay, so the Wednesday before last Wednesday.
They did their first reveal.
Yeah, the first reveal was revealed to be revealed on Wednesday. And they revealed...
revealed to be revealed.
Some stuff in the tower, how the tower's going to work.
Yeah. Destiny Year 2.
Destiny Year 2, basically. And see what your life in the tower will be like. And for a quick synopsis, vault space...
Doubled. I had to steal
exotic
the thunder
blueprints.
There. 72 weapon slots, 72 armor slots. General is staying the same, but it's different because there are kiosks elsewhere.
Yep.
So just tossing that out there. 72 slots each. It's huge.
Yeah. So there's a ship and there's a ship's kiosk, there's an emblem kiosk.
I love that. That's going to be great.
There's a few other kiosks. And there's also some kiosks that haven't been talked about. There's one by the Vanguards that is off a little bit. And people are thinking it's because it has the same quest symbol on it. And people are thinking it's a Grimoire.
You would think they would talk about that, right?
And there's also another kiosk by the ship kiosk near the ship handler. It has a symbol that we're not too sure of. I can't remember.
Grimoire is huge. I would think they would talk about that. I wish it was, though. That'd be so great.
Yeah. But, yeah. And so, yeah, exotic blueprints. There wasn't really anything much else covered. They showed a lot of stuff about your light level and how that's going to work. Basically... your level isn't tied to your armor. It's tied by your progression in XP.
Your light is your power
level. Your light is tied. It's basically your item levels.
Yeah. It is how strong you're going to be, which is really cool. Yeah. I like that a lot. They showed off like the quest and the bounty system, which is great. Yep.
The inventory, all that good stuff.
Yeah. They didn't really go over the equipable emotes, sadly, but we can imagine how that would work.
And artifacts were shown off in the last one.
Artifacts are a little odd.
Swords.
Swords.
They showed a teaser and they teased the new dance moves. And it's pretty amazing. That's basically the synopsis of the first stream.
Well, here I have it up. I'm gonna go through it a little bit and like see if there's anything we missed. There's the here's the dance moves for people watching the video. There's the sword right there. It's just chilling out while he's doing the sprinkler. Exotic blueprints you talked about. That's pretty big. I don't really care too much.
Probably won't use it.
Me too.
I listened to the Planet Destiny podcast, and they were talking about how they should have done this. That it should have been somewhere you can store your exotics.
But we already
that are fully leveled up.
Yeah, I don't get why. You have to like purchase another one of the level
and then level up.
It's really weird. Gunsmith.
Yes.
Went over Arms Day, which is really cool. The reputation is awesome. I really like just the idea of the field test weapons. Like you go out and do crap with this, and then you get rewarded. Like it's so good. It's different too. Yep. I'm so excited.
And you get rewarded. Oh.
Weekly Crucible. Bounties.
Mm-hmm.
Showed a little bit of that. A little bit. Just a little bit.
Yep. Nightfall rewards.
Yeah. Oh, that's so awesome. I'm so excited.
For Nightfall tier rewards, not Nightfall rewards, but Nightfall esque.
Oh, Cryptarch sells legendary engrams.
Yes. That is
which huge. Is really, really good. That's really cool. I like that a lot.
Legendary marks. Also, legendary marks are replacing Crucible and Vanguard marks.
Yeah.
I'm sure this is all news since it's been like 2 weeks now since we've.
But since we're going over it.
We're going over it.
I really do like the legendary marks thing. I think it's really cool. Oh, there's no cap to how many legendary marks that you can earn in a week, but you can only hold 200, which is awesome. I really like that a lot.
And so you basically, and also what I think is happening, if I understand it correctly, every week they're trying to reduce the feeling of, okay, I have to get on all three of my characters and do all of these things. They're trying to make you have the ability to focus on your hunter or your warlock. So basically every reset, say like you run the heroic playlist to get your if the strange coins were still there. Yeah. By the way, strange coins are not going to be there anymore.
Nightfall will not kick you to orbit as well. Crazy stuff. Yes. Crazy stuff.
But I'm saying, like, say if you got on today and you wanted to do your heroic strikes, you go in and you get your 9 coins, and then you just keep going, you get another 9 coins, and you go again on the same character. And you get your third set of coins instead of having to go throughout all three characters and doing it. It's account based. A lot of this stuff is account based now.
Yeah. So, which I like.
Why?
There's
no reason not to.
Except for that, I like running it on all three characters.
Then do it.
I think that's fun.
That's you have the option to. It's amazing.
But you don't get the rewards. You get the rewards account based instead of all three characters. Like I just like I like. Back in the day,
when No. You know how you have three. Right now, you can do the heroic strike 3 times. It's gonna be the same thing, but you have the option to do it 3 times on one character, 2 times on one character.
Oh, I see what you mean.
Yeah, you have the options. You could probably, if you want to, do all three characters. No one else cares, but But I personally might want to do it on my Hunter three times.
That's interesting.
It just reduces the need switch all the time.
I guess. But to be honest, I like that. But at the same time, I kind of don't. Because I'm like, if that's the case, I'm never going to leave my Titan. You know what I mean? Like, I'm always going to be this one character. And I like switching because I like seeing the other classes. But, you know, I'll try and force myself to switch, I guess.
And you're going to have to anyway to play with the new subclasses.
Yeah. But one day, those are all going to be leveled, you know.
I heard people have been talking about the Stormcaller outclassing Voidwalker.
That's
a big words there. That's coming from a developer, I think.
Yeah, it makes sense.
I can see it because...
Yeah, I can see that.
DPS versus the instantaneous effects of Voidwalker Super.
Yeah, I can easily see that. That makes sense. Let's see, is there anything in...
Maybe not outclassing it, but overall, like, lethality.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel you. I feel you, homie. So... next reveal, they went over the Shield Brothers strike, which was really cool to see. I liked it a lot.
We got to hear a full-fledged Nolan droid.
Yep, we did.
It was good stuff. Apparently, there's probably cutscenes that we didn't see, obviously.
Yeah.
Same thing for the mission that was shown on several YouTube. They also showed the first mission of the Taken King.
Yeah, they kind of just like...
Not in the live stream, but just they
released allowed the, it. Yeah, they ended the NDA for that, and all the YouTubers who had played it and recorded it were like, oh, well, it's up.
Yeah. They showed us a lot of new stuff there, and with the... basically, that the second reveal was mostly... going over the subclasses, see what they are at the moment. They can still change. They honestly still could change.
There's a lot less of a chance that they're going to change now than there was, like, a while ago. Because now there's, like, you know, there's, like you were saying earlier, there's, like, friggin' 15 days. It's, like, two weeks until. So, but they still can.
And I feel like a lot of stuff is going to be finalized when the 8th comes around.
Yeah, I feel like things are going to be real finalized in a week from now. Like, a week from now, that's probably it.
Yeah.
We got to see Mr. Fruit use the sword a little bit.
Yeah, just, not just from his perspective.
Just a little bit, yeah.
He blocked with it.
Yeah.
And
I thought it was funny, throughout the whole strike, he was like, man, if only I had a heavy weapon. that would be real useful right about now.
Let me guess. Right when we start the next stream, everyone's gonna have a sword out and like ready, and everyone's like, "Whoa!"
That would be great. That would be so good. Here's John Cena going around for all the people watching the video.
Da-da-da-da.
Oh, it's so good. If I could find that video, I could show it real quick, but might take longer than it's worth. But I've been playing gameplay of or video. Of the two reveals while we've been talking. So there you go. There's a Stormcaller. Oh, looks so good. I'm excited. I'm very, very excited. So what we learned from the most recent weekly update is that 2.0 is going to come out on September 8th, which is awesome. I like that we actually have a release. We also learned a couple of things about 2.0, but about 2.0. Not in the update. We learned about it on people's Twitter.
Yeah, and it's weird because we thought most of the stuff was going to come with the Taken King, but after thinking about it, they were wanting to make 2.0 like really substantial update. It's kind of weird how they're doing it though, but
yeah,
I'm not complaining.
Yeah, I mean we get stuff, or, you know, a week early, which is cool, I guess. It just kind of messed up my brain. I was like, what? Why? But yeah. I'll take it. Here, let me. I'm going to find all of the info, if I can. The thread isn't here anymore. It's not on the front page.
By the way, Are you going to be busy on The 15th?
Oh, yeah, probably. What day is it? Let me see. Oh, yeah. It's Tuesday? Yeah. Oh, well.
Yeah. I mean, oh, my gosh. Tuesday? Really?
Yeah.
That's my longest day of the month or the week because I have
you got a bunch of
classes all morning and then I probably will work in the afternoon.
Yeah. I'm trying to find the thread that I can't find. You know, we're talking about Destiny, so it might be Deej Nuts. I saw that in the comment earlier. Oh, here we go. I found it. All right. Here are two tweets. One says the new quest system for year one content and updated Ghost will be available on 9/8 alongside the 2.0.
So this means Nolan Droid will be in the game. This also means that if you are starting the game or you're doing quests and all that, you will have them in the new order and
very interesting.
The new, like, I'm sure you know this, but like,
I was gonna read.
There's a new order of how.
I was gonna read Luke Smith's tweet too, which clears it up. Says the North Ghost leveling revamp and the previously announced questification of content will apply to all of Destiny in the 2.0 update.
Yeah. So and you'll have 16 bounty slots, the quest, the 32 quest slots. What else? Tracking.
Tracking is gonna be really cool. That's gonna be really cool. The quest system sounds so much like sounds just so awesome. I thought it was funny. I was watching the Game Informer. They did like a podcast where they talked to Luke Smith and Mark Noseworthy about stuff. They just asked a lot more questions, and they were like, they said, is there going to be any sort of quest line with Petra? And he's like, oh, yeah, you go to Petra, this happens.
Apparently it happens very early on, too.
Blah, blah, blah. And I'm just like, oh, like, it sounds so good. There's actual story, Eric. It exists in the game now. And I'm very, very excited.
It's going to be amazing.
It's going to be so great. Well, that is most of the Destiny stuff.
That and then seeing Cade 6. Nathan Fillion is just so good for Cade 6, honestly.
Yeah, I don't know.
Does it very well.
Yeah, I don't know much about Nathan Fillion, so I can't say too much.
I mean, he's Buck.
I'm excited. Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
It's about all, all I know.
He says, yo, in the tower.
That's
basically all I know, but we know he's witty. I know that, and it makes me really happy. Cause I feel like he's gonna be like the robot Nathan Drake, of Destiny.
Okay.
Even though it's very weird that Nolan North is over here, in the Ghost.
It's true. It's unexpected. But September 8th. Be ready for that, and then also be ready for September 15th. Also, be ready for all of these games coming out from the drop. Oh, triple segue! Oh my gosh.
I was really hype-pitched.
Triple segue. Holy crap, I'm going off today. So there are two drops to cover because we weren't here last week. So I figure...
Obviously...
I'm just going to read off... I think what we should do here, Eric, is we should literally...
Or we
I'm going to read the first
forget
page.
All these other games and say which game was the best.
No, I'm going to read each one, and then we'll just highlight. Like, I'm not going to read the description. I'm just going to read the title of each one. And then when we're done reading each list, we can be like, all right, here are the highlights. So, blowing through it. Here we go. Amnesia Memories, PS Vita. Back to Bed, PS4, PS3, Vita. Calvino Noir, PS4. Capsule Force, PS4. Dishonored Definitive Edition, PS4. Dying Light Demo, PS4. I Am Bread, PS4. Madden NFL 16, PS4, PS3. Mega Man Legacy Collection, PS4.
That's big.
Nova 111, PS4, One Piece Pirate Warriors 3, PS4, PS3, and Vita, Shut Shimmy, PS4, Vita, Digital Crossbuy, Steins Gate, PS3, Vita, Tina's Toy Factory, PS4, and Until Dawn, PS4. V.
Oh, that game is horrible. It's, I mean, it's a good game, but yeah. It's...
Oh, that was the first list. All those games are already out. So there you go. Highlights. Well, we'll go over the next list and then we'll highlight all of them. There you go. Next list. You want to do this one?
Yeah, sure.
New releases for September 1st.
Okay, so we got here, Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons.
Missed Armello PS4.
Oh, I didn't see that. Oh, Armello. Yeah, I'm not used to this new setup.
Yeah, I like the setup, though. Oh. I like it. It looks good.
Ryan Clements.
Oh, yeah, Ryan Clements, PlayStation Powerhouse. Thank you so much. All
right. Yeah. Armello, Bunnies, Rabbits, Tigers, Bears, Oh My. Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons. Talked about that one already. Danganronpa, another episode. Ultra Despair Girls, PS Vita.
That's actually good. Danganronpas are really good, from what I've heard. Really, really good.
Looks like Teddy there back in the background there.
Monokuma is his name. Colin's a big fan of Danganronpa.
Okay. Alright, Disgaea 5. Disgaea. Alliance of Vengeance. Disgaea. Okay, Disgaea 5. Alliance of Vengeance. Demo.
Yeah. Disgaea, I think, is just a JRPG from what I've heard. It says the latest SRPG. Wonder what the S is.
Huh. Super RPG.
That's exactly what it is. Instead of 500 Disney hours, Infinity, it's 1,000 hours.
3.something.
3.0.
Freaking Wookiee looks really... Where is that Chewbacca?
Looks awesome. Really... Freaking Star Wars.
He looks really... I'm gonna get you.
Oh, yeah, Wookiee... Oh, yeah. Chewbacca does look kind of... Oh, my gosh.
All right, guys. Fat City. It's here.
Oh, Fat City.
We got Grow Home, Grow Home, Mate, and Rethink Your Life.
Wow.
Mad Max, that's big.
Yup.
There's
a lot of big things. The fall is
holy
here.
Holy crap, this is actually happening this
the
week?
The fall is here.
MGSV, The Phantom Pain in
otherwise
my leg.
Otherwise known as Metal Gear Solid 5. Oh, wow, dang, dude. Dang, son.
But yeah, MGS5, dude, that's huge.
Otherwise known as Metal Gear Solid. yeah, it's big.
I didn't think that, I thought that was coming out closer to The Taken King for some reason.
Well, it is pretty close.
Well, I thought there was something else coming out on the same day that people were like, this is gonna totally get shut down by MGS.
Yeah, Mad Max.
I thought it was Taken King, I don't know.
No. Mad Max is... Everybody's been saying that Mad Max is going to be delayed because of Metal Gear Solid, and it hasn't been.
Yeah. All right. Guys, this is the game we've been waiting for our whole lives. 19 years as a human on the planet of Earth. The Muppets Movie Adventures. It's finally here after years of development and high-quality production.
The biggest JRPG on the planet.
200 hours across the board. Extra side missions that never end your gameplay experience.
It's like Skyrim. It's literally infinite.
Yes.
Infinite Muppet
next
adventures.
We got Nobunga Gogoga Ambition. Sphere of Influence. Why is there a
Whoa.
Sphere of Influence?
Look at the next game.
That we already covered this, though.
Yeah, that was last week. Nova 111.
Wait, was
that
one
was on
a demo?
Last week's list. No, the other one's normal. This one's normal too, and it has a different picture. And
maybe
different...
they want to come. Maybe they want to compete with MGS.
That's interesting. All right, let's go.
Space Hulk.
Space Hulk Vita.
Squares.
Trial. PS Vita.
Super Time Force Ultra.
Yeah.
You've been talking about this. I don't know what it's about, but yeah.
I'm telling you, you're going to like it.
Zero Drifter demo. Zero Drifter plus demo.
Oh, yeah. It's probably the game plus the demo for the game.
Okay.
That's our free PS Plus, just saying.
Oh, okay. Zombie Vikings.
All right. That is the list of games that are out
guys,
and
don't
have
wait.
Come out.
In PS Video, we got Pitch Perfect 2.
Oh, my God.
Game of Thrones season 5. Okay, that's actually relevant. There we go. Spy and Poltergeist.
Okay, highlights. Dishonored Definitive Edition. Pretty cool. Yes. Dying Light is a demo. Download that demo. If you like the game, buy the demo. Buy the game.
Mega Man Legacy Collection.
Madden 16? The fall is gosh dang here. The fall is freaking here. Until Dawn. And that's from that other list. And now this list. Gosh dang. Also Brothers? Buy Brothers if you haven't. Danganronpa is apparently one of the best Vita games out there. And this is like the third one. Disgaea 5, I've heard a lot about that series, but I don't know. Disney Infinity 3.0, those statues look, the Star Wars figures look gosh dang awesome. That's all I have to say about that. Grow Home is our Chewbacca free one.
Looks a little creepy, though.
You need to see the freaking statues, dude. They're so good.
Infinity. He's just over here like, I'm going to crash the ship into this asteroid. No it one knows it but me.
Oh my gosh. It literally does look like that, though. It really does.
Like when he's crashing into the asteroid, he's just like,
gosh dang, dude! Holy crap! I'm trying to get this picture, but it ain't working. Oh well. Oh well. Okay, continuing with the highlights. Grow Home is free for us. It's on PS4. Mad Max is looking really good. That's a highlight. Metal Gear Solid 5.
Basically Batman.
Definitely a highlight for people who have been waiting for Metal Gear Solid for, like, gosh dang, 5-8 years, however long it's been.
I've been waiting for the Muppets movie adventures for 8 years. Yeah,
yeah, dude. Super Time Force Ultra. I have been waiting for that game for, like, 2 years. It is free. PlayStation Plus. That is amazing. Zeo Drifter is also free. PlayStation Plus. Look out for that. And those are the highlights. And I have to go because Fear the Walking Dead.
Yeah.
We're gonna get on the road at 6. So I got like 15 minutes. I gotta get this rendering while I'm gone. So, yeah. Thank you for joining us. Reach out to us on Twitter if you enjoyed the podcast. I'm at 2PCX. As we said earlier, he is at LegendPBM. And let us know how you like it, and let us know any sort of feedback that you have, and we're going to show you something random, and then we're going to leave, because that's how we normally do it. Eric is showing you goldfish, and I'm showing you a racquetball. This is the best thing ever.
Also, I've probably already shown goldfish, but here we go. I have this beside my desk. I have, like, everything I need here. And I found some lighters that I found on the ground outside. I don't know why I have them, but I have a lighter here for burning things if necessary.
Yeah, you know, you never know.
You never know if you need to burn something.
Zombie apocalypse.
Destroy arson. You know, arson, normal stuff.
Yeah, you know, normal things like that. Your average everyday activity.
I also, this is actually really interesting. I have a collection of the pieces to earphones, the earbuds. Mm-hmm. I have like a whole collection of them in this top drawer from like over the years. And if like one of them breaks, let's put a new one on.
There you
it's go. Great. It's great. Life Collect hacks. Your earbuds. That's Life a lesson. That's a moral.
All right. Well, we will talk to you next week and we'll talk some more about Fear the Walking Dead because there's actual TV to watch now. It's pretty great. Drink root beer, eat goldfish, get a racquetball and bounce it against the wall, and that is it. Bye. I can't reach the button with the waving.